There are only two ways how to get free Microsoft Office, and in this video I will show you both of them. When I said get free Microsoft Office, I meant only completely legal way to get it. I will not talk about all those other ways. Here we go. Click on Windows icon and go into Microsoft Store. Here click on a search button and type Office. Now you need to click Show All, and we are looking for this icon. And it says right here, it's free. Now I will click Get. And I will install it. When it's installed, I can launch it from right here. When this window pops up, you can create a Microsoft account if you don't have one. You need only an email address, but I will click Sign In as I have several accounts. This is what it looks like. If you think that you can install Office to your computer by clicking here, you can't. This is free online version and you don't have to pay for it. Microsoft will try to sell you subscription though. Free Office apps and 5 GB of free OneDrive storage is very decent from Microsoft. For example, if I open Word, I can make a new document. It will be open in a browser as well. This is a little watered down version of the Word, but for vast majority of people it will be more than enough. I can rename my document by clicking up here. When I go to save my document, there are several options, including saving it as a copy to my computer. That's great, as you can send or carry that file anywhere with you then. I will save this one onto OneDrive Cloud. And here it is in my cloud. The best part of this Office online experience is that you can upload any Office document onto your OneDrive and edit that here. For example, this Word document was not made here online, but I can upload that and work on it here. Then I can save it as different file, like version 2, then download that to my computer. Everything goes. You don't even need to install this small Office app I have done before. All you need to do is go onto office.com and you can work on your Office using Microsoft account from anywhere. To finish up this free option 1 and Microsoft Office Online, it's great, fully functional. The only two drawbacks is that you don't have all the bells and whistles full version of the software has, and you do need internet connection to work on it. That's all. Now, option 2, how to get Microsoft for free with all the bells and whistles installed onto your computer. That means no internet connection is needed to work in Microsoft Office. For this option, you need adult, teenager or a kid with any connection to academic institution, school of some sort, either employee or attending. If you ask someone from your family, that would be best. That person needs to have an account. That means email address issued by that school, and you are set to go. I have the same Office 365 license with all the apps installed on 2 computers, my wife's and my daughter's. I haven't tried on more as I have my own Office 365 subscription, mainly because I need OneDrive storage. Anyway, you need to go to this page. Here you should type school email address. Now you have 2 choices and I will choose student, because this is my daughter's email address that school gave her. I'm sure any employee would do here fine as long as he or she has school email address. This next click will take you to the website of the authority who has all those school email addresses stored in its system. In my case, in Croatia, this is that authority. And here we are. This is Microsoft Office 365 that belongs to my daughter Lara. All those things I showed you in online version of the Office, you can do here as well. All the apps are here. Working on a document, uploading a document, everything. Big difference here is this small Install Office button. When you click on that, you can install full Office to your computer. You download this small app and do the install. I did it on 2 computers with no problem. Both can work at the same time in the Office. That is very important. I will not do it now because I already have Office 365 on my system. So, you will need school email address and password and you are set to go. The only drawback of this option is that you will see the same account info on all the computers, and if you wish to use OneDrive Cloud, you will have to share it with multiple people. It's not a big deal, especially if you are in the family. If you have found this video useful, take a look at my other videos. Like, comment, maybe even subscribe to my small channel. I don't upload much and you will not get tired of me. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye!